All right, what you working on, Pops?
Patching this here hole for Care Bear.
So back in here, oh, it's hard to breathe already. We got all these doors here. They're all nice and painted. You see that pretty gloss on them? They're attempting to dry in this very lack of oxygen room. We got the ceiling done. You can see the nice luster there. We got all the trim is done. No runs, no flaws, none of that. Same thing in here. Can't breathe, so you know something's been happening. All the doors are painted and looking good. Getting a nice coat of overspray primer on the wall to cover up the blue. And same thing in here. Fresh coat of paint on the ceiling and trim's all done. So we have done everything we can do beyond this mark until this paint dries. So we're gonna let it dry and start prepping our next stage, which is down through the hall, including this bathroom. Last night we picked up this nice LED light fixture since we realized we were moving most of our light fixtures. Makes it hard to see, especially when it's doing that outside. We do still need to undo this and check the seal in there because I think that's shot.
This is our next little project. This is the upstairs bathtub bottom. This is, that there is the main drain. And as you can tell, it looks like it's been leaking for a little while. So we're just looking into this to see how much. There's a 2x4 there. I wonder what that's going to tell me. Anyway, so I got to clean this out, cut this big enough that we can actually patch it better. So I'll probably cut to that 2x4 and out and around. And get that plumbing fixed.
As well as do the repair to the ceramic tiling. See, there's a chip there and then a chip underneath there. And then we're waiting the last second to remove our porcelain throne because you got to use that from time to time. Even though we're working in a nasty place, but you know, it is nasty. And the rain just sped up, so that means it's getting more wet. Slide back past you. See, if we come back out here, and you can see the amount of water. Now the problem is all our tools are out those steps, turn around and come back in into the garage. And it's kind of wet, just a little bit. As you can see, wow, that's right there. You can open this door so you can actually see it out the window. Yeah, I'd say it's coming down. And to think, I was gonna paint the outside of the house today.
Yeah, don't worry.
Not happening. So we got all the prep work done here in the kitchen that we're gonna be able to do until we're actually ready to start attacking the kitchen. All right, good morning. We're back at it again. It is now Saturday again. This is the third Saturday I think we've been here. And the weather's starting to cooperate. There's not a cloud in the sky. So we're gonna try and get back out here and get going again on the exterior. I've got my pops inside. He's still working on getting the interior done. We're working in sections. I think I mentioned that in a previous video. And the hall back, so the bathroom, the closets, the bedrooms back in the upstairs area. All the trim's done, all the doors are done. Gotta wait for it to dry so we can mask and then do the next stage of paint, which is just the walls. And then we can start reassembly on those rooms. So while he's doing that, because the weather's cooperating, I'm gonna go ahead and start working on painting the exterior of the home and get it going. Now, one of the biggest things we've been working with is neither of us have used these particular paint sprayers. I've never used an airless paint sprayer before, so we're fighting a learning curve a little bit on them, but it's still going faster than doing it the other way. We did notice we bought, for the inside, we bought a 5-gallon jug of semi-gloss white paint to do the trim and the ceilings and things like that. Now, initially, we weren't planning on doing the ceilings, but we've already finished off the first 5-gallon jug in just that back section, so we're going to have to get at least one more 5-gallon. So we were quite a bit short adding in those ceilings. So, yeah, expect to always need more than what you expect. So, anyway, where I'm going to work, what I'm starting on, and I debated about this initially, I wanted to start on the foundation first to get a good feel for the gun, what's going on. But the problem is where it rained really bad yesterday, everything's wet, the concrete's still cold and wet. So we decided to divert our attention upwards. And I'm gonna start on this eave and soffit and fascia and work my way around the back and come back around the front and reconnect. That's where I wanna start to get this thing going. The fun part's gonna be, I'm gonna have to stop painting right here somewhere so I can get up on the roof and do all of that. Where it's green right here will be the lighter gray of all the rest of the house. But all the brown and where it's white actually up there will all be this newer color. That's kind of funny looking up underneath there, underneath the eave. That never got painted from the green. That was always that tan color. It never made it the tan color. I don't know how I never noticed that, but oh well, whatever. Anyway, we're gonna go ahead and dig in and get this thing going and see what we can do. Okay, so this morning we went ahead and we started painting already. I got this shield. Basically just a spray paint shield. Pretty handy idea, but the problem with this type of thing is you are spraying such a large fan. This doesn't do real well.
You can see how much overspray I've gotten on it, and that was in just a short period of time. I'll show you where I had done when I did that. And then, so I had made it to just right here. So I had sprayed this, and I had sprayed all of this. And if you look closely, you can still see overspray that had gotten around the edges. And I still have some touch-ups I gotta do. But with doing that, I realized I was wasting a lot of time and a lot of energy trying to use the shield when the shield wasn't doing its job. So I started masking, and I think I'm getting a lot better results. So we went ahead, we masked the window, because I even got some overspray on this window down here. So I masked the windows, I masked the meters, I masked the back upper half of the house, and now I'm ready to start spraying again. So I want to show you what it takes to spray with one of these. I'm sure there's lots of videos out there of how to do it, but I'm having fun. Let's turn you, and you can sit and watch and see what it takes to do the up and down. Right now I've got the paint sprayer here, but I'm gonna have to move it once in the midst of this process. Portion of the house and start getting it ready for paint. So maybe I'll bring you along for that, maybe I won't, we'll see. Hey, welcome back. Sorry, I know it's a little windy. It is now Monday, and I figure it is about time to get you caught up just to where we're at on a few things. Inside there's not a lot to look at. We finished the trim in the back hall and it's being masked. That's it. Masking takes a lot of time, but it'll pay off in the end, so it is what it is. As far as outside, what I've been working on, let me turn you around and give you a look. So this morning I went ahead, finished masking, and painted the foundation all the way around. We even painted the sides of the steps, and you can tell we weren't worried about overspray, none of that. And I believe last time we had finished the soffit and fascia, so making good headway. It's been windy, so it keeps trying to pull all my masking off, so I'll have to touch that up before I get back to it. If we walk around the corner, you can see what else I've started. There we go. This whole side has been painted. The only thing left is doing the 3-inch trim that'll go around the windows in white and pulling the masking off. If we walk around the front, same thing here. The only difference is we do have to do the trim around the garage. We are going to have to paint that in place. And we did notice at the end of this series, I'm going to show you some tricks I learned, but I did get some overspray there in a few little places, nothing major. But if you get overspray where you painted it, that's not too big a deal. But we got all of this painted to here, and then again, the foundation's all done. So really, if I step way back, you know, even with my wide angle lens, this doesn't do a whole lot. You can see the whole house is pretty much painted. Minus the trim and removing the masking. So I'm hoping to be able to remove the masking off the front of the house and probably off the rest of the house today, assuming all goes well. Paint really has been going really well. The only complaint I've had so far, two complaints, both related though, is this gun. This is on the Magnum X5 True Airless. Love this thing, it works awesome. The one thing I don't like though is the gun does not swivel on the hose. So you fight, because it's a pretty stiff hose, especially when it's pressurized up to whatever PSI this thing holds for the paint, which is obnoxious. So that's one thing, but because of that, when you're grabbing it, you can't grab it and squeeze because the rest of your fingers are in the way. So I think I'm gonna modify this trigger and make it a shorty, probably cut 2 inches of it off to make it so you can hold the gun, manipulate the gun, and have a trigger finger to do the spraying. I'm sure this is for if you're doing a lot of spraying, but the fact that there's just not, you just can't hold the gun stable and then pull the trigger really bothers me. So I have to keep flipping on the gun lock or the trigger lock. So that's my complaints with the X5. And the funny thing is the Harbor Freight version does have a swivel. So anyway, that's enough of that. So you can see here, got the foundation painted. We have not done this side or the back, which you saw a minute ago. Still debating on this. You can see the texture's not real pretty, but it is painted, or it is filled with that Rock-Tite stuff. So it's solid, it's not going anywhere. But yeah, so there we go. Everything is masked, other than what the wind keeps blowing off. So as soon as I can, I'm gonna paint this side next, get to here, paint that side, and then I can go back and start doing little touch-ups and just get things finished. So super excited. It is going really quick, which I'm happy about, because that's why I bought the airless. So anyway, I'm gonna go ahead and put the camera down and get back to work.